This video contains approaches for planning, communicating, testing, and applying a ServiceNow instance upgrade. Each ServiceNow release contains major additions and enhancements to platform functionality. These additions and enhancements may include new applications or features that can improve operations, productivity, and system performance. When planning your upgrade, a good first step is to review the release notes. Understand the fixes in each release version, notable changes for the user interface, browser support, and plugin updates. ServiceNow feature enhancements include major additions, and it's a good practice to consider the impact of new functionality on your instance. The number of instances can impact the length of time it takes to perform a system upgrade. The most common scenario is 3 instances. If activities are overlapping, coordinate a date and time to freeze activities in both test and dev environments until the upgrade is complete. With each release, a checklist is available to help ensure that you complete all the tasks for a successful upgrade. It's never too early to start using this checklist. To locate the correct version, start by going to the ServiceNow product documentation webpage and drill down to them through the appropriate release family. You can save the checklist as a PDF. In the checklist for the newest release, there are 7 phases. These phases are great guidelines and milestones to use when you write your project plan and weigh the amount of internal support you'll need during the upgrade process. Planning is crucial to the flow of implementation and should be given much attention and thoughtfulness. Writing a project plan will help you identify teams, responsibilities, and assign estimated time requirements for individuals. Use the plan to obtain early buy-in from stakeholders and teams. Each upgrade cycle is an opportunity to evaluate prior records. Use the Upgrade History module to locate and resolve upgrade conflicts. In the module, you will be able to view the most recent upgrade records to see what was skipped, updated, inserted, or deleted. Note any objects that were skipped so you can manage customizations efficiently. Create comprehensive test plans that include test cases for core system functionality, regression test cases for all applications that are in use, and integrations. Testing will not only save time in the long run, but it will help ensure that your instance is in good standing before the rollback window closes. Your testing team will vary in size, but as a general rule, the more testers you have, the better. Ideal testers include IT admins, engineers, and computer technicians. To estimate a realistic time frame for upgrading the production instance itself, clone the production instance onto a sub-production instance and use the upgrade monitor. With a well-prepared project plan, inclusive of test plans and the right teams in place, the time required for the entire upgrade process will be significantly reduced. ServiceNow's customer support is readily available to help you with your questions. Once testing is complete, schedule a walkthrough with key stakeholders and the core team. Obtain necessary approvals for the production instance upgrade. Send clear communications to both key stakeholders and end users detailing the anticipated production upgrade outage timeframe, new system features, how users are directly impacted, and what users need to do to prepare. Now you're ready to upgrade the cloned instance. To begin, request an upgrade from ServiceNow Customer Support. Select the family release you wish to upgrade to and schedule the upgrade. Use the upgrade monitor to follow the progress. Once complete, perform regression testing, track and remediate defects, and create an upgrade process document that outlines upgrade steps. This document should also include helpful information, like what errors might occur and how to remediate them. Upgrade all other sub-production instances. Upon successful completion, you can now request an upgrade for the production instance. After the upgrade is complete, you can now promote, preview, and commit update sets that contain fixes from the sub-production upgrades and perform regression testing for all core functionality, applications, and integrations. Now, validate your results. Activities on sub-production instances that were put on hold before the upgrade may now resume. All instances should be in sync. communicate availability to stakeholders and users, and attach any supporting documentation. An upgrade will provide you with a better experience and improve automation. After all, most functionality improvements come from customer requests. When you're ready to begin an upgrade, start by saving the checklist and write a project plan. Reach out to ServiceNow's customer support at any time. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.